On this Women's Day, we have with us someone who has left the entire nation talking about her work, the film Lipstick Under My Burqa. Her directorial movie brought about a new wave of change in the way women's sexuality is being presented in Bollywood movies. An alumni of the prestigious Lady Sriram College and Jamia Millia Islamia, Alankrita Shrivastava brought women-oriented film at the center stage by taking us to the non-metro city, showing us the ordinary yet extraordinary women among us. Many thanks, Alankrita, for joining us. It is an absolute pleasure talking to you on the occasion of International Women's Day. It is, of course, something that a lot of women, in fact, have aspired to be a filmmaker. But as a filmmaker, what has been the challenges that you have faced as a woman in your career?
I think that I feel like I kind of started off on a very optimistic and positive note. I think I wasn't thinking too much about the fact that it's a male-dominated industry. I think I just wanted to, you know, work in feature films, and I started off as an assistant director, you know, with the Prakash Jha Productions. I was assisting Mr. Jha. So I think I just kept like sort of working my way up. I didn't think of myself as very different from you know, my other friends who had also come to Bombay and who were, you know, who were boys, who were men, and they were also assistant directors. So I did feel a sense that, you know, we were all like, everybody was trying to sort of make a space for themselves and just climb the ladder and, you know, just do their best. I think it was, and in fact, my first feature film set, which was Ganga Jal, I remember there were hardly, like, there were just three girls on set. There was me, there was a hairdresser, and there was a costume designer. But I don't know, it's so weird. Like, I didn't even think that was odd. I guess I wasn't thinking so much about the fact that there are not so many women. But I think later, as I continued to work, in retrospect, I can say that I think I was constantly, like, compensating for the fact that, you know, there were such few women on set. And often I was, like, you know, in a situation where I had to run a set which basically consisted of only men, and I think I became very, very aggressive. I had a very, I think I wanted to inspire fear, you know, amongst everybody on set. I used to shout a lot, I used to scream a lot. And I think I did take on, you know, I brought out various personality traits, which perhaps, I think was it a subconscious, I mean, it was subconsciously because I knew that, I don't know, I had to be taken seriously. So I think a lot of that stuff you start understanding a bit later when you sort of look back at the journey. But I think I just put like my nose to the ground and I kept working. And I was very, very fortunate because, you know, I had a wonderful mentor in Mr. Prakash Jha, who really like sort of encouraged me to do my very best and never made me feel like I was lesser because I was, you know, a woman. So I think that encouragement went a very long way. He also produced my first two features. So I think it was all about hard work and just, you know, doing what you need to do. But I think when I started making my films is when I started realizing how much discrimination there actually exists, because that's when you realize that it's so difficult to, you know, get distribution for a film that is led by a woman if, you know, you don't have a very big star. And I think those kind of things, then suddenly you start understanding how unequal things actually are, because, you know, there's a certain kind of film that always is the kind of film that will get the kind of commercial, financial, marketing support, and a certain kind of film that always will be pushed on this, you know, on the sides, on the fringes. So I think when I started writing and directing and putting my own work out there is when I became much, much more aware of the kind of imbalance that exists in, you know, in the film industry, particularly because I feel there are not enough films that are made from the female point of view. And I think that has been like a sort of learning curve. And I think that made me also very, very conscious of the fact that I think I have like a particular point of view, a particular perspective, a particular gaze, and I really want, you know, to stick with that gaze, explore that further, because I feel that's what's not really done so much in Indian cinema. So yeah, that was a long answer to your question.
Well, absolutely. And in fact, you were just speaking about discrimination at this point. Alankrita, in your opinion, do you believe that Bollywood is perhaps doing enough, or are we still painting a rather regressive narrative for women?
I definitely feel like, we are a very patriarchal society, and our cinema has played a huge part in sustaining that patriarchal structure through, and endorsing that patriarchal structure. And I think if we just understand that, popular culture and cinema has been shaped by the male gaze, because it's the men who've been the deciding people vis-a-vis these films, the sort of history of films that we have. And then the female point of view has largely been missing, because there have hardly been any women behind the camera. So we are in a situation where a lot of things are just taken for granted in terms of how women are portrayed, even in terms of how men are portrayed and the relationship between men and women, whether it's talking or using the camera in a way that does not connect at all to the narrative, which is objectifying the woman. And the audience also has become conditioned to watching cinema with with male eyes, and with patriarchal eyes, actually. So I think it's like a vicious sort of cycle. And again, I think there's always that excuse of commerce, put it because show it because that's what works. And there's a sort of lack of responsibility that producers, writers, and directors seem to have vis-a-vis the content that they are putting out. Whereas I think that there should be a certain sense of responsibility. I should take responsibility for the images I'm putting out, for the stories I'm telling, for the kind of characters I'm putting out, and for the way I'm encouraging the audience to look at those characters. So I do think that, largely I feel, that sort of patriarchal system continues vis-a-vis cinema. There has been a shift, because with new age filmmakers, many more women are being there on crews, many more women writers and directors compared to earlier. So I do feel there has been a shift. I think the shift is also there because I think the digital space has opened up and the audience is more open. Having been more exposed, I feel, to other kinds of content, is also a little more open to films which are not necessarily exactly run of the mill. So I do feel there is a small change, but largely, of course, things need to change. And I think the real thing is that there's been no space for the female gaze or for alternative points of view. So everything we've been conditioned to watch has been watch it like a man who wants to perpetuate patriarchy, which is why, the martyr of a mother, the virginal love, the sacrificing wife, those kind of boxes, or that vamp who's supposed to be full of desire, but then she's a negative character. So women are constantly being portrayed in ways that just suit men, and therefore the censor board, which is what I had said even when lipstick, they had tried to stop lipstick, is that, I don't know how it is now, but at least at that time it was you feel they are not at all looking at anything with a nuanced kind of way. They're just interested in they feel the status quo is fine and it can continue. But the thing is that the status quo is not fine. And the status quo encourages a way of looking at men and women both that needs to be challenged. So I think this kind of nuance where, and I don't believe in censorship at all, so I don't feel at all that, a certain kind of thing should be stopped. But I just feel all kinds, all points of view should be available for people to engage with. So I do feel, of course, this hypocrisy exists, but that hypocrisy exists because our society is like that. And I think the purpose for me, I feel the purpose of art, the higher purpose of art and cinema is always to challenge the status quo and, see how things can shift. And I don't think cinema can change things, but cinema can be like a mirror. It can start a conversation. So I always feel like it's important to not just keep continuing whatever society, however the society is sort of functioning, but rather to see if, examine and explore what are the ramifications of how our society is.
Absolutely. And you have been a role model for many. What will be your message that you want to put across to all the women who perhaps want to aspire like you have and want to make a mark like you've done?
Yes, I have. I definitely have a message for women on Women's Day. I think that I think it's important that we put ourselves first, and we give precedence to our desires, our dreams, our ambitions, our needs, because I think we often tend to put ourselves second. I think we need to feel more entitled. We own the world and we have a right to the world, you know, the same kind of rights that that men have. And I think we need to feel that sense of entitlement, which I feel we don't. I feel we're always like sort of apologetic. But more than anything, I think I would really like, I think on Women's Day, a message should be given out to men, because I think women are doing quite well and making the most of, you know, of difficult situations. I think men need to sort of participate in the movement for equality. So I think like nothing is going to change unless that patriarchy shifts, and that will, it does mean that men need to sort of not get in the way of women and actually help pave the way for women to move forward. It can't, the onus can't just be on the women. I think, you know, men need to be held accountable, and an equal world is going to be a better world for everybody. So I think it's high time men start participating.
Well, it has been an absolute pleasure, Alankrita, talking to you, and definitely you're going to be inspiring a lot of women to live their dreams. Many thanks for joining us on this show.